I think there's loads of challenges on this because of being a live show with Skype added into it, with health problems, with loads of contributors at home effectively directing themselves, calling in live on the show and getting on air by the end of the show, as well as all the multi-platform aspects of sort of play-along health tests as the show went out. But we had an amazing team, so that's what brought it together.
There's so many different elements there kind of being mixed together. What was the most complex or challenging specifically?
Oh, I think probably the Skype element was the most complex because lots of people, I guess, had to do it themselves in a way at home. So trying to get that set up for them and helping them do that was the most complex. But it all worked fine in the end, so we're really pleased with it.
Yeah, I think, I was saying before actually, that we're here tonight to celebrate all the amazing crafts people in television production, and yet we were asking, you know, sort of ordinary members of the public to sort of sit at home and sort of, you know, to be in control of the audio and the visual with webcams, you know, with sort of varying sort of degrees of sort of techno know-how, and integrate that into something. So it did take, you know, it was a real fusion of, you know, a multi-platform, well, across so many different platforms, actually. So it's the future.
Do you think that level of interaction and home technology represents the future for television? Do you think more shows are going to be trying to follow your guys' pioneering footsteps?
I think we showed the limitations as well as the possibilities of it, because it's not perfect and it's not built for broadcast. But if you can accept that as a new way of doing something, it can work really well and add something to it. And I think factuals are really tricky area to try it, but things like entertainment, game shows and so on, I think there's a real excitement there about what it can bring, as well as stuff around things like medical shows and stuff where you can really add something by someone being at home and feeling comfortable in their own surroundings and opening up a bit more than they would under studio lights. It's really an interesting balance as well.
Are we going to see more of the show? I mean, are you working on what?
Tuesday night, 8 p.m. Channel 4. Bigger and better, and hopefully having learned from some of the sort of the first that we did in series one.
So what's going to be bigger and better about this series then?
The set.
Yeah, the sets.
I think the series one almost felt like six pilots going out, because we're trying new stuff every week and changing loads of stuff around based on audience feedback and user feedback and what worked and what didn't work with technology, whereas series two, we know what has worked and we can ramp up all those elements. So I think the whole thing will feel bigger and will feel like taking all those learnings, and this is the result
polished.
Of it.
Yeah. We're more polished, but as Dan sort of said, we're still sort of going to be working with people from their home with limited sort of technological sort of, you know, technology at their hands. So, you know, we'll see. It will still be quite live and unknown, I imagine.